This guy's amazing. If you don't know him, you need to connect with him or join 10X Vets or all that. He's the bomb. But I remember when I first connected with Scott, I was so intrigued. This was the diamond that didn't know it was a diamond yet back in what, Scott, 16 or 17? And yeah, we connected. One of the things you did, Scott, that maybe I would love, Jason, if Scott could share on it, was you created, you just said, you have to be doing something that you're excited about. What you and I think your wife did was you created a vision board. He just spoke to my cohort over at the Lions Pride recently, and they were blown away because a lot of them had not done this, but now they're doing it because they respect Scott so much. So Scott, you created this vision board. You weren't happy more or less where you were. You felt like there was something else. You created some sort of vision board. I don't remember the details, but I know you do. And then that thing, as I recall, pulled you into this next chapter of your life. True or false?
All right, Scott, what's a vision board?
Yeah, so I don't know if it's being futuristic or whatever, but like whenever I was kind of like in a low spot or just wanting to be escaped from where I was, like I would create these vision boards. And so one place was, the winters in New England. Like I was just burned out, you know, from the traffic, you know, living outside of Boston to all of that. And we wanted to move. We came to, actually, my wife and I created a vision board. And we sat around one night, you know, in February with a couple of cocktails maybe. And we're like, hey, if like we could live anywhere, not because like we grew up here or because our jobs are here, like where would we live? But we couldn't come up with a place. We're like, I don't know, there's a million places. So we're like, all right, forget naming it. Let's just describe it. And so we put by the beach, all right, close to an airport, on the East Coast, warm most of the year, in a great neighborhood. So we listed like all these, a description of this place, but we didn't know where it was or what it was or anything like that. Put the vision board or whatever, you know, put it in a drawer. And then a year later, on our 10-year anniversary, we took a trip and ended up in Charleston, South Carolina. And we went out, it's a little beach just outside of Charleston called Sullivan's Island. And we went there, I had never been to Charleston before. And we hit the beach and like immediately, I got like this electric like shock, like down my spine. The vision board, like this is the place. And anyways, but that was kind of a story that helped us, you know. And then I think 2 or 3 years later, we figured it out financially and moved to Charleston. But like anything that you want to do, like even if you don't have a name for it, or just write down like how you want to feel or what you want, like the description of what this thing is that you want. Don't name it, because I think you limit yourself when you put a name on, like, you know, an exact name on something. Just describe it. Describe what you want to be doing each day, or what the customers you want to serve. And then I did that again with, you know, I think with Brill's cohort, you know, I talked about, you know, when I started, you know, SABM or kind of started doing that full time. It was kind of the same thing. So kind of a side story there, but. Mm-hmm.
I don't think it's a side story, bro. I think it's a main story for most people, whether you're in trajectory, but you know, you're en route to Mars, or whether you're preparing liftoff or you don't even know that you want to lift off. I think that right there, what I actually observed in your timeline was so powerful. And I remember I remember you surfing on Sullivan Island. I think there was a surfboard involved. And you hadn't surfed in a long time, but I think you rented something. And I think I could find in my phone a picture of beers on the beach. And it was like, this is the place. And it wouldn't have been the place if you and your wife had not done all that pre-work. And most of us get really busy with life and we never do that pre-work. And so we're unprepared for the beer on the beach and the surfboard rental and all that, and then making the decision that this is it.